next concert series. Tonight's sponsors include your friends at Bob FM, also CJH Television, the Ottawa Citizen, and Rideau Carlton Racetrack Slots. And folks, my name is Brent Corbet from CJOH, here for a great show and evening with Tom Cochrane. If you missed the news, by the way, today announced at the Corral Center on September 27th, Shania Twain is coming back to Ottawa. Shania Twain on September 27th, and tickets go on sale this Friday. Also, tickets went on sale today for Matchbox 20. They're coming to the Corral Center on October the 6th. Tickets went on sale today. Folks, there is Tom Cochrane merchandise for sale, stage left. That's your right. Take home a piece of Tom Cochrane. This is an evening with Tom Cochrane. No opener. They'll be out here shortly. And please enjoy the Super X concert series all week long. Go to thex.com and find out more about Matt Good, Theory of a Dead Man, and so many more. Folks, coming up in just a few minutes, Tom Cochrane. Enjoy the show.
Thank you. great to be back here again, twice. Didn't we play the other night? This is, we thought it was canceled. The first time ever I can remember losing two shows because of power, because a week ago we were in Thunder Bay up around the lakehead. North of that, we lost power because of lightning, but power's back on. How you guys doing? You doing good? I'm gonna play a bunch of songs. Man, you guys make me love my job. I love my job! You make me love my job! We're gonna play a bunch of songs. And, a bunch of Red Rider stuff, and we're gonna play a bunch of stuff on Mad Mad World. We're gonna keep on going.
Hey, Jones. You okay? I'm strapped in.
Are you guys ready? Jeff Jones on bass. This is a song that's off the Victory Day record. And a couple of some people up from New York that asked about this song. I signed some things for them. This is to you guys. This is it's off the Victory Day record. It's called Victory Day.
Thank you.
sometimes your dreams come crashing to the ground, but they can rise again. This is called Sinking Like a Sunset.
Thank you.
Randall Stahl back on the drums. Give me. This is my son Steve over there that just grabbed me. There's a song in town, it's a, not a new single, but it's been out for a couple of months, but I'm real proud of it, it's done well, you guys have responded to it, but more importantly, it's inspired by my two daughters, Cody and Evan. It's called Pitches from the Edge. But then he said, he proceeded to tell me that he was a star in a hockey team and he had a scholarship in the States. And he said, you know, he was so busy. He was so busy with his school and his hockey, and I was so busy with business and that, that I don't feel like I really got to know him. But talking to him, I really think you always can say that. You can always say that. I got a feeling he was a pretty good dad. So on the bigger scale, in a sense, this song is about how we pull together as a community, and I think that you guys in Ottawa, you guys show that more than anything about this song. This is your song. This is the big league.
Down. You never can tell. Back in the days when we were
I think some of the best songwriters in the world are Canadian, you know what I mean? You've got a lot of incredible songwriters. This is Damhnait Doyle, give her a hand. She's going to be playing the guitar solo, and I'm going to sing.
BS, family show.
Anyway, so she's got a great, really good record out called Damhnait. Dabs?
Not having
it. Alan's away.
Yep. This song is called Afterglow. I don't know what you're going to say. It's going to
well, play. She talks a lot, so once you get going, I'm just going to...
No, you have to play with me.
Anyway, she's been out for a couple of months with us, and she's... She's been out with us for a couple of months and she's been really a good sport. but she wrote this song called Afterglow, and every once in a while there's a songwriter that writes a song that you feel like you wrote it yourself, and I think that's what it's about, isn't it? But a songwriter writes these songs and you feel like you wrote it, and you feel like I wrote this song because it hits me right here. It's a great song.
I will tell you about it, baby, but you were there. You were with me, too.
It's called Afterglow.
Nobody really wants this life, no matter what they tell you.
Look like Sonny was here. Satisfy my output, and that's really why I got into a band. But I remember at one point I was driving a cab in Toronto. So you think SARS is bad, but driving a cab in Toronto is bad. So I did that for a while, and I remember it was a hot July day night, actually, and I was outside Massey Hall. And this gentleman is one of the greatest singer-songwriters, as far as I'm concerned, that the world has ever seen. He's a great Renaissance man. He's written some wonderful books of poetry as well. He wrote this song. I heard it wafting through the doors because it was so hot they had the doors open. And I'm going to play it for you. And again, it's one of those songs I feel like I wrote because it's so close to my heart. This is by the great Leonard Cohen. It's called Bird on a Wire. Thank you. drunk. Like a drunk in a midnight choir. I hear you try. Get my way to be free. Second single off the first Red Rider record, so it goes back a long way. And judging by a few people in the front rows before they were gone, like this song. It's about a girl that went to New York. She went to New York to study acting. It's called Avenue A. I always wanted to write a campfire song. Because nobody appreciates summer more than Canadians do, you know what I mean? There's a song. It's a campfire song. You gotta exercise a little bit of suspension of disbelief, because there's not usually steel guitars by campfires in Ontario, but Ken Greer, give him a hand.
Anyways, okay, so we got a generator.
A generator bar. You sound like you're in good voice tonight. Good voice tonight? This is about coming of age by a lake in Ontario in the summertime. It's called Good Times.
Yeah.
This is You should see him with his makeup on. This is now a few months ago, actually last October, I was involved in a Muhammad Ali tribute, the great boxer, one of the best boxers I ever lived. But more than that, he was a statesman. And this song is sort of about him, but really about my dad. Because my dad, as far as I'm concerned, was the most important hero in my life, you know. And he was a champion. And a few years ago, I had to put him in a home because he had Parkinson's disease. And he said to me, Tote, that's my nickname, Tote. He said, Tote, I'm gonna get through this. I'm gonna beat this thing just like Ali. So I wrote that down. This became a song and we released it as a single and it did really well. And the proceeds from the single went to Parkinson's research. So I'd like to thank everybody over there. I'd like to dedicate it to Miles tonight because it's about the spirit and how the spirit survives. And Miles is a very spiritual person. It's good to see him tonight, him and his son out tonight. So this is for you guys. It's called Just Like Ali.
Well, I'm wasting what I can see now. Battered doors that ain't no matter. Bye.
Now I'm returning, I got back up and I got myself back.
sometimes you think about something and very often it's kind of something really silly and you think, man, why should this be preordained or whatever, you know? Like you think of a song and you hear it on the radio. It's like somebody up there is playing a big joke on you, you know what I mean? Anyways, I wrote this song a long, long time ago, and I ended up going to this place about 13 years after I wrote the song. It was kind of everything I imagined, only worse, in some ways. Not to bum everybody, I know it's summertime, and I don't want to bum everybody up. But in a sense, the song is inspiring in some ways, I suppose, because it makes us think. Anyways, it's about a French poet that wrote three books of poetry and he gave it all up to run guns in Africa in a place called Somalia. And I visited there a number of years ago on the day. I was there the day the Marines landed. There are more guns and more gunfire than I ever want to see again. And I can't imagine people living like that. But they do. They do. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, while we enjoy our freedom. Anyways, this is, and I'd like to say something about our Canadian forces because I think they do an incredible job. We got no one as peacekeepers. And God bless those guys. And also God bless World Vision because I went over there with them and they save hundreds of thousands of children's lives every year. I'm very proud of the work I do. Anyway, this is a song. It's about Leonard Cohen. It's about Arthur Rimbaud. And Arthur Rimbaud wrote three books of poetry. Illusions, The Drunken Boat. For the moment, I can't remember the third one. It was, he inspired people like Bob Dylan, Joni Mitchell, and Jim Morrison. This is called Way Hot.
you don't stop and you say it's so, I'm gonna pack my things and go. Hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back.
Left you there, this is wrong. These are the hits, one that gave
guys have been unbelievable tonight. We love you.
Ottawa rocks. Sister Coolest Face, Zipping Scout and Stone, don't you leave me in this place. Like a boy without a home. 1917, true story. We had passion, we had dreams. I thought the love we were fighting for was something more than something more. soul.